Write the function in vertex form and find the vertex. We have f of x equals 3x squared plus 24x plus 51. First thing I'm going to do is subtract the constant term, both sides. So we're going to get f of x minus 51 equals 3x squared plus 24x. Now I'm going to go through and divide everything by 3, trying to get the x squared term by itself and making finding the trinomial we need a lot easier. So I'm going to divide this side by 3, everything, and then divide 3 here, divide 3 here. Okay, so I'm going to recopy the left and simplify the right a little bit. So f of x minus 51 divided by 3 equals x squared plus 8x. Now we need to know what constant term do we need to make the perfect square trinomial. Take the 8 from the middle term, divided by 2, and then square it. 8 divided by 2 is 4. 4 squared is 16. So we need a 16 here. We'll add 16 to both sides. Left side is starting to look kind of weird. We'll just kind of recopy it and then deal with simplifying it later. So all that, and then plus 16 equals x squared plus 8x plus 16. Okay, I'll recopy the left. And again, it looks strange, but don't be too worried about it. Just keep going here. X squared plus 8x plus 16, that is going to be x plus 4 quantity squared. And now we can get into simplifying the left-hand side. First I'm going to subtract 16 from both sides, and that's going to make, well here, I'll do the work over here. I have f of x minus 51 all divided by 3, and then well, we're subtracting 16, so that's going to equal x plus 4 quantity squared minus 16. Now we're going to multiply everything by 3. What we're trying to do is we're trying to get this back into function form. So we want f of x on the left and then everything else on the right. So that's kind of what we're doing here. That's why we subtract 16 and then we're going to multiply by 3. So f of x minus 51 equals, and it's going to be 3 times x plus 4 quantity squared, and then we're going to need to do 3 times negative 16. It's negative 48, so we're going to have a minus 48 here. I'm going to draw a little separating line through here just so you know that this scratch work isn't part of the main work over here on the left. Okay, so finally, we're going to add 51 to both sides. So that's going to leave f of x equals, and negative 51 plus 51 is 0, 3 times x plus 4 in parentheses, and then squared, and then negative 48 plus 51 is 3, so plus 3. So there's our function in vertex form, and if you're thinking this is a long process, you're absolutely right. You know, you just have to be patient with yourself, take it one step at a time. Finding the vertex, that's easy now. It's just negative 4, 3. And you read that from the vertex form. Okay, so let me go through this process one more time. First thing we did is subtract the constant term from both sides. Then because there was a coefficient besides 1 in front of the x squared, we divided by that coefficient. In this case, it was 3. And that made it easier here to make the perfect square trinomial. And the unfortunate side effect is the left side of the function looks pretty ugly, but that's something you have to deal with. There's no real way around that. Then once we found that number for the trinomial, we added to both sides, wrote it as a perfect square binomial, and then simplified the left-hand side. And as we did that, we put the function in vertex form, and the vertex is -4, 3.